Stop stalling, Park. That's our show.
Hello.
Hey.
Thank you all for being here for Wednesday night at the Pack.
Yes.
It's the beginning of hours and hours of comedy this evening. Thank you so much for being here for the 8 o'clock hour, where we have the Deconstruction, who's going to come onto the stage in a moment. However, before the Decon comes up to the stage, we have a few house rules we need to announce. First, for anyone who hasn't been to the Pack Theater before, welcome. Thank you so much for being here. The Pack Theater offers classes in improv, sketch, digital, two-person workshops, and a slew of others just waiting to start. The next session begins in September. Please go to packtheater.com to find out more information. The Pack Theater is... I need to take a breath. The Pack Theater is a pay-what-you-can theater, so the entertainment that you see here tonight, admission is free. That seat is free. However, on your way out, if you can put something into the boss vase, whatever you want to call it, or if you're paper money challenged, you can always donate at Pack-Theater on Venmo. Lastly, for anyone who needs to use the facilities, you can step out of the theater, go to the sidewalk, look at the double doors.
You are killing it.
I know. I don't know why. Which is so jarring. When you see the glass double doors, just go down there and walk about 30 feet, then you'll see two gender-neutral restrooms. Which means you don't have to wait as long as you used to 6 months ago. Those are our house rules. You're here for entertainment, you're here for comedy, you're here to be moved. So please, let's have that happen. Start clapping.
Oh, yeah.
And please welcome the cast of the Deconstruction!
We're the Deconstruction. We're going to do some improv for you. All we need to get started is a line of poetry or a lyric from a song.
I want to holler.
I want to holler. Thank you.
No! You first!
This isn't working out?
No, shit!
was that not it?
No, it's just not, I didn't want, I thought, like, in the back of my mind, I was sort of like, maybe he feels like I've been neglecting him. You know, like, maybe he feels like, you know, like I've been super busy or something, and you just like miss me so much. No?
I do feel that, but I, it's kind of a deal breaker. At this point, I thought that this was what this was. I came over here 10 minutes ago. You haven't said a word to me since. I'm here now. It just feels like it's over.
No.
If you want to talk about it though, come on. Maybe we can work it out. Maybe we can work something out.
Okay. Yes, please. Let's talk about it. Let's work it out.
Sure.
Do you want to sit?
All right.
I'm going to sit too.
I don't feel that there is room in your life to accommodate my needs.
What are your needs?
Fuck.
I appreciate that.
I just, you know, like if we can work this out, I definitely want to.
Me too. Oh my god, me too.
I did.
Wait, let's start from there. Let's just start from there.
But here's the thing. I'm wondering, given how badly this fits right now, if the only way to make it fit is like to, like, when you like morph a puzzle piece so that it fits a place where it doesn't go, like you deface it, and then it's like, that's not a fucking cloud, now that's a Jackson Pollock painting. And some people like Jackson Pollock paintings, I kind of hate them.
Me too!
Okay.
So we have that?
I
don't get it. I don't get modern art. Like, if I go to the Getty, I want to see, like, you know those watercolors from,
listen,
like, the 18th
century? I get it. We're on the same page. Sorry, keep going. Getty watercolors, sorry. I never let you speak,
see,
you're always letting me speak.
When you cut me off like that, I speak, my brain is like a bunch of trains on a track, right?
Right.
And so, like, the trains go forward, and then sometimes I have to jump onto another train, and but then I'll get back to the original train. You just have to stick with me for a second.
That's a really weird metaphor. Wait, you mean so they're all driving parallel with each other, and you're hopping back and forth?
Yeah, they're like thoughts. They're like trains of thought. So, like, right now I want to talk about the Getty.
Is that what trains of thought mean? Okay, sorry.
Plus, my parents really like. But that's another train. The point is, like, if I go to the Getty and I see, like, a watercolor that was, like, painted in, like, the 1800s, and it's, like, so intricate and beautiful and detailed, and then, and it's amazing, and it feels like art, but then if I look at, like, a Jackson Pollock painting or, like, some of that modern stuff, I'm like, who's that guy who's there right now who does, like, all those photo essays, and you, like, look at his, there's a picture, I swear to God, it just looks like an Instagram selfie. But it's like from 1974, which is interesting, but all I'm saying is that, like, I don't get the art of, like, modern art.
I agree.
Right?
Yeah.
See, so we have that. It's like that stupid song about we have breakfast at Tiffany's or whatever, and I think about breakfast at
Tiffany's. Said I think I remember that
film. Yeah.
But it's like, can you really build a relationship off of
breakfast? Well, probably not. I mean, like, it's a stupid song. It's a bad metaphor. All I'm saying is...
I actually really like that song. It's a guilty pleasure.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, I like Backstreet Boys.
Me too!
Oh, really?
Yeah,
I always thought you were an NSYNC girl.
Mm-hmm. No, I was both, but you know, when I was in high school, and I was like, my favorite NSYNCer was like Lance Bass, which I think is just so sad.
Because he had the eyes.
Yeah, and he was kind of like the quiet, weird one who didn't talk much. And then it turns out he's a dumbass.
Really?
Yeah.
I've never heard him talk.
Oh my god, he was on a $100,000 pyramid a couple weeks ago, and he was so stupid.
Look, what are we doing?
I don't know. I just feel like this is connection.
I think we're forcing a connection still.
God.
I mean, come on, we've been talking about museums and modern art, and now we're on fucking Lance Bass being a dumbass. Like, what else is there?
Okay, do you want me to quit my job? I'm trying to get back to something substantive, right? You said that I don't give you time, so like, how do you want time?
Look, I feel like what a good relationship is two people that are running as fast as they can towards a specific goal,
yes,
that is theirs, and that they meet somebody who just happens to be running in a way that complements that without obstructing it. And if you feel like you have to leave your job for me to be happy, that's a definite sign of dysfunction.
No, it's not. Because it's like, yeah, we're like running in a direction. I don't love my job. I love you. So, it's like, that's not the answer.
It's just that I would never give up managing the Subway franchise for you. Like, that's my thing. Like,
I'm not asking you to. I'm saying, I can bend.
But is it, what about your dignity?
Hey, really nice shirt.
Oh, thanks, you too.
I don't think we're gonna die alone.
No, I think as long as we keep running and keep looking good,
yeah,
we'll live forever together.
So what are your, like, goals in life and your aspirations? I want to start a family by the age 32.
Oh my god, me too. That's the exact age I want to start a family.
Oh my god. We fit.
Oh my god, you've been perfect! We'll never be alone, we'll be perfect forever!
Yes!
Oh my god!
I can't wait to tell my parents!
Oh my god! I can't wait to tell my parents and your parents! Oh my god!
I can't wait for my parents to be your parents and then we can tell
said,
yeah. And I was like, fuck. Fuck. Right?
Yeah, but that's it. It's just you. Because when you ask such a big question like that, it's gotta be, fuck, yeah.
I was just like, I thought, if I ask it, that's enough. But,
you're right?
But it keeps going after that.
Just the guts that it takes to go from maybe. Oh, I'll ask. Wait, I have to ask again?
Right? Like, that's not what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to let me off the hook.
That's right.
Thank you.
It's not like guts goes on forever.
No, they have a very short half-life, the guts.
Sometimes it takes a full tank of guts, and then you use up that tank, what do you got? Nothing.
Oh, I got nothing. Now I have to get married.
Are we inviting your uncle?
Mm-hmm. Everybody has an uncle, Larry. My uncle Larry just happens to actually be named Larry. You know?
Okay, that's weird.
No, you know what I'm talking about? Like what an Uncle Larry is?
No, what's an Uncle
Larry?
Uncle Larry
is like a creepy uncle who like means well, but like everybody's like, I hope Larry behaves.
My uncle died in a duel, so.
How have you never told me that?
Because. It's just weird. It's so white trash.
Like an actual.
Like a pistol duel.
Like in what, 1994?
96.
Still! Hey! How does that work logistically? I mean, it's the same rules?
It's not quite the same archaic rules of Code Duello. It's more like you just show up at somebody's house with a pistol, and then you give them 5 minutes to get their pistol, and then the first person down loses.
And is dead.
Well, unless you like kneecap them. Yeah, my uncle pissed off a lot of people. It's embarrassing. Like,
no.
like I'm happy that your parents are so nice to me. Like, they're so great.
They love you.
But like, when I'm over there, I constantly feel like I'm being probed by them.
No. They're just curious. My dad's a lawyer. I mean, you can't help it.
Oh, shit. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. No, it's that, no, like, the thing that they love about you is, like, I grew up so, like, easy, and you grew up in chaos. But you, like, pulled yourself out of chaos. And like, my dad thinks that's amazing. Like,
why did he grow up rough and tumble?
No, not at all. My grandpa did, my grandpa on my mom's side. But no, my dad went to Yale. Like,
oh, okay.
I'm just saying, like, all they care about, like, all they want is for you to take care of me, to love me. Like, that's all they want.
That's all?
Yeah.
They're not worried about your security or anything like that?
No.
They're not worried about being joined matrimonially to a bunch of crazy people from Kentucky?
No. I mean, my family's crazy too, just like in a khakis and polo shirt kind of way. But they're bananas. My mom is, you know.
Oh yeah, your mom's fucking
crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and she's like way post-menopausal. Like, you should have been around, like, in the middle of that whole debacle. Because, like, she went through menopause, and my sister, like, came out of the closet, and then they became Catholic. All at the same time.
Shit.
I know! I'm Tennessee?
Wow. I guess everyone's a little crazy.
Ah, Henry, what a beautiful ceremony, hey. Why don't you sit Uncle Lawrence over at the table with the bridesmaids?
I'm actually really uncomfortable putting Lawrence anywhere near a group of women like that.
Come on. I'm going by Lawrence. Larry's gone. Lawrence is here now.
Right. Sorry. I different tie. I don't think that. This was a very expensive reception. We want everybody to have a nice time. Want everyone to be relaxed. Okay.
And you know how the bridesmaids will have a nice time if I'm at the same table with them.
Well.
Come on.
You are kind of dashing.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Tell you what. How about we'll find a table with some lovely ladies who just all happen to not speak English. That's a good compromise.
So you're gonna make me work for it then.
Mayor Gilbert!
There you are. You armed?
I'm armed. It's 1996, let's do this.
All right, what are we counting to?
I say we count to 1996.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Guys, I'm sorry. You're gonna need to exit the parking lot.
We got a situation that
we
need to deal with.
I don't care. We are so tired of you trying to reenact Hamilton in the public library.
Listen, Miss Gilbert. We'll be out of here in 194
seconds. 7, 8, 9, 10. Wait, no,
let go! Oh, God! Don't hurt any of the hostages. Are you recording this? We have to be getting all this on tape. How many hostages have you got?
I don't think there's anyone in there. You've been yelling at this building for 3 hours.
No. They're in there. They're just cagey. Now, we don't want any bloodshed, you understand? We want everyone to get what everybody wants. What do you think of that? Are you getting this?
I can tell you what's happening. The automatic lights are turning off because no one's in there to set off the sensors. It's dark. Look, eventually I'm going to get into overtime. As long as you sign off, I'll stay on the
phone. Well, my mama told me, better safe than sorry. We don't want any bloodshed. Let's figure this out. I want to work with you. Oh, what? I'm getting something.
That's a mouse farting.
This is not like how it was in Poughkeepsie. Poughkeepsie, we had hostages up and down the street every other week.
Yeah, we've all heard about Poughkeepsie.
Yeah, I thought I was getting into the big action here, but no, here in Fayetteville. Now listen, maybe you're in there, maybe you're not.
Well,
but we want everyone to feel like they're part of this community. If you're in there, you're one of us out here. So why don't you come on out, let's talk about it. I thought that was pretty compelling.
All right, Denise, I'm ready to get back in the dating game. I'm gonna be a contestant on Love Connection.
Oh, and Beatrice, you're so cute. But as much as I want you to find love again,
yes,
the odds aren't even against you, they're infinitesimal.
You're an asshole. I've still got.
You have the hips of a younger person.
That's right.
The spirit that you did.
Yes, I do.
Way back when you married Uncle Roger.
Yes, he was my second husband, and do you know that I have been engaged 3 times before that? I was known in my day as a barracuda.
That sounds great. I just don't want you to get your heart broken when you're out there and looking for love. Let love find you.
Well, that's a horse of a different color.
It's gonna happen. It's gonna happen.
But I need you to understand something.
Sure.
I'm not getting back in the dating game for love.
Oh.
Mom needs to get laid.
Aw, oh, and Beatrice. Alright, jurors, show of hands, who here's from like a really shitty part of the country? Alright, everyone else you can leave.
CA number 12.
Alright, show me $2 for a sandwich. Alright, show of hands, who throughout their childhood woke up on a morning basis covered in spider bites?
Bye.
All right, show of hands. Who here is drunk right now?
I was just wondering. This isn't like what the video was in the lobby at all about civic duty.
We just want this to be as impartial as possible, and we find that the most chaotic citizens make the best choice.
Checks out.
All right, you two are the jury.
Service.
Oh, okay.
All right, Matt, this is it. No changing your mind at all.
I agree.
Good. It's been a hell of an effort just to get you here. It's gonna be fine. You'll back him out. Your life is set. Once you enter those doors, you'll have the best job that you'll ever have. You'll have people who will support you for the rest of your life. You'll be taken care of.
Well, if I'd known that, I would have shown up sooner. What exactly is behind those doors?
It's heaven, man.
Oh.
You can't back out now.
God.
You
Sorry.
Can't back out now.
Suicide is kind of a one-way street, isn't it? Yeah. No, you're just, all right, well, I'm ready to go in. I want all those good things.
Good. It's finally time that you get something good.
Fire flames, fire flames.
Oh,
fire
God.
Fire flames, fire flames.
Did I say suicide? I meant saving babies.
This is happiness. Fucking embarrassing.
Yeah.
It's just like I don't like it when you see that side of me. I don't like it when anybody sees that side of me, and it's just fucking like I just feel boxed in. It just erupts.
Okay.
What are we doing?
What do you mean?
You're really gonna stand at the altar with me tomorrow?
Yes.
I set your parents' house on fire.
So?
You are not. Oh my God.
I committed to this. You just.
But commitment.
Did you set the house on fire just to try to get out of this?
I don't know. I don't know why I did it. I freaked out. I blacked out. I don't know what happened. But it's like we're having this conversation again,
yeah?
And I feel like to you, commitment is the only virtue, no matter what you're committing to. And that's fucking scary.
Yeah, it is.
So why?
Because it's the only thing that makes sense. Every train of my brain that has figured out every possible scenario of my life, if it doesn't involve you, it makes no sense.
That doesn't make any sense.
Why not?
I still don't understand the train analogy.
All right.
get into the probulator. Time to get probed. I said get into the probulator. Assume the probing position. A guy gets to know you better before I give you this job. There's straps, you know what to do.
Yes.
Hey, have you probed that candidate yet?
He's hesitating.
Where are my khakis?
Oh, come on, Morgan!
You
come
know
on.
What happens when I don't have my khakis and polo shirt? The change!
Hey. You know what happens when I don't have my overalls? Come on, Kentucky's just as crazy as Oregon.
Wait, you're Uncle Larry?
Yeah, I'm Uncle Larry.
You're Uncle Larry.
I'm Uncle Larry.
I'm Uncle Larry!
I'm Uncle Barry.
Get out of here, Barry!
Welcome to Fayetteville. We don't really know what happens here.
It's clean.
Do the leaves change colors?
Sure. Yeah, we got seasons. Winter, spring, summer, and fall.
Sun rises at 6:50 every morning, sets at 6:30 every night.
That's true. To be perfectly honest, I'm not actually sure what state I'm in right now. I
think it's a state of confusion.
Subway. Every day of the week, we've got a $5 Tuesdays, Black Forest ham. Wednesdays, meatball marinara. Subway. Eat fresh.
That's a cloud.
That is a star.
That is modern art.
That is bullshit.
That is dialecticism.
I don't know what that means.
Then I win.
Come on, honey, it's the express train. I'll get you into the city quicker. Don't deal with the local. Come on. Wait, I'm such a good employee. You can't fire me.
I can do whatever I want to.
Are you armed?
Yes.
All right, we're dueling for this employment. Commitment. Ah! Yeah,
that's not the answer I was expecting, so it's wrong. What is 8 minus 5?
3?
No, different expectation. Incorrect. What's the capital of the United States of America?
Washington, D.C.
That would normally be right, but not to me. You see? That's how you play this game.
Get buried by 32.
Cabo!
I'm dead by 37.
Okay, I did this before. I'm not telling you.
Hi.
Hey.
Hi, I'm Lisa.
Hi. Oh, yeah, you came in here last week.
Yeah, I love turkey sandwich.
it's fun to meet you. Yeah.
Sorry, what was your name?
Trent.
Trent. You think it's trash?
A little bit, yeah. I'm a little embarrassed by it.
Shoot, I've never met a Trent before.
No. Well, then.
Hi.
Can
I get Mustard?
Yeah, can I get your number?
Yes!
Yeah.
do we have the podcast coming out there?
Dude, this is your last show, man.
Yeah.
Don't do this.
Wait a fucking minute.
Hey, you know how you can find out? Go to packtheater.com right now on your phones while you're sitting in the audience.
Well, you'll see the full schedule of tonight's entertainment coming up.
Indeed.
All right.
Thank you
so much for all being here.